Hello viewers, today we're going to change the timing chains of this BMW E39. This is 3-liter diesel engine, the legendary M57 engine. This is going to be the first time the timing chain is going to be serviced, so it's going to be interesting. Is the chain stripped or wear out at all? We're going to compare it with the new timing chain. So right now the car is at 255,000 kilometers and we're going to see what is the wear of the timing chain on that mileage. This is all the parts that we're going to use in the timing chain service. So this is the gasket for the timing chain cover, the oil pan gasket, the valve cover, the intake manifold gasket. This O-ring is for the vacuum pump, the crankshaft seal. These are the copper seal for the injectors, crankshaft pulley bolts, there are 4 of them, the engine oil that we're going to use, Moto X-Clean 5W40 full synthetic, the oil filter, the air filter and the 2 timing chain kits. I believe this one was for the camshaft to the injector pump and the other one is for the from the injector pump to the crankshaft itself. The kit came with the hydraulic lifter and the plastic guides. So it's always a good idea before starting work to disconnect the battery. I'm going to disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. We have some aftermarket subwoofer. I'm going to untie the negative terminal of the battery. And going to leave it like that. So I'm going to start by removing all the decoration covers, the clutch fan with the fan itself, and we're going to continue from there. The next step I'm going to use this special tool for removing the fan clutch. This is for locking the water pump and this 32mm ratchet is for undoing it. Don't forget that the fan clutch is with a reverse thread. So my mistake, we're going to need 2 32mm ratchets. I took one and with the grinder I make it thinner, so now we're going to try to undo it like that. So this is how we're going to attempt to undo the fan clutch. Okay, so after a little bit struggle, we managed to undone it. And now I'm just going to rotate the fan to be able to remove it from the water pump. So after removing the dust cover, I'm going to undone this clamp to be able to remove this air intake holes. And after that, because we're going to remove the water pump, it's a good idea to drain the coolant from this drain plug. By this we're going to reduce the mess that we're going to do. total amount that we managed to drain from the drain plug of the radiator somewhere around 3.5 liters of coolant.
And the total quantity that this car has inside the coolant system is 10 liters. So there is a lot more coolant in the system, but going to try to capture it with some pen when we're removing the thermostat housing.
Okay, so the next step that I'm going to do is to drain the engine oil. I'm going to remove the other dust cover. I'm going to drain it because I'm going to remove the oil pan. It's not mandatory to remove the oil pan when you're doing the timing chain service, but I prefer to do it because it's the way you should do it. This is the proper way, in my opinion, to change everything. While I'm waiting the engine oil to be drained, I'm going to remove the small serpentine belt for the compressor itself. By that I'm going to use 16mm ratchet. And now it's a good time to check the pulleys. This one is changed before 10,000 km and it's okay. But the bearing on the compressor doesn't sound very good. Yes, it's making metallic noises. So we're probably going to change the bearing of the compressor because it's gone. But the bigger serpentine belt, I'm going to remove it from the top. It's much more easier. I'm going to continue with the removal of the intake. After that I'm going to remove the injectors, after that the vacuum pump and the EGR pipe. When removing the injectors, it's a good idea to mark each one of them from each cylinder that it came, like in this case 6th, 5th, 4th and so on. So it's a good idea to mark them after when you need to reinstall them, you're going to know when every each of them is going. After removing the thermostat housing, the serpentine belts, the vacuum pump and the injectors, it's time to remove the valve cover. And after that, I'm going to start to remove everything that is attached to the timing chain cover, which includes the AC compressor, the pulley tensioner for the AC compressor, the hydraulic pump, the alternator, everything should go apart from the timing chain cover. So I'm going to remove everything from here to be able to remove the timing chain cover itself. Just want to say a few words about the removal of the valve cover. Except all the bolts that have to be undone on the end of the cover, you should undone the middle studs. On the stud there are a nut which you can put a 10 mm socket so to be able to undone the stud itself. These studs, if you remember right guys, are for the injectors. So all the middle studs should be undone to be able to remove the valve cover. Okay, we had some struggle removing this tensioner, so I want to show you some tips how to remove it. You just need to undo this nut from behind 10 mm, and after that with some I show you how we remove it with some shakiness and with a lever. We managed to remove it because there were a lot of rust inside. And probably we're going to change this lever because it's wear out. And if you want to remove this part, the spring itself of the tensioner, there are two bolts. One of the bolts is located here and the other is between these ribs here, where I'm pointing with my finger. This is the hole for the other bolt. So you need to undo these two bolts to be able to remove the tensioner itself. Okay, so pretty much everything is removed from the timing chain cover and I'm almost ready to start to undoing all the bolts that is holding it in place. Before that, of course, we need to remove the crankshaft pulley, which is held with 4 bolts. But before any of this, we're going to lock the crankshaft with the special tools. So this is the tool that we're going to use. This is for the camshaft locking. This is the holder for this piece that is holding the camshaft. One of these two should lock the crankshaft to the flywheel, so it's pretty tight there, but I'm going to try to show you where is this cap installed. I'm going to zoom out. This is the starter motor and the plug that you see, guys, is for the crankshaft sensor, and in the middle of the screen there is the other end of the bolt for the starter, and right there I'm going to point you out. Right here, inside between these two grills, there was the cap for the crankshaft locking tool. So I took the pliers and just reach inside with them. And I used the bolt for a lever and I was able to take the cap off from here. I'm going to show you with camera how the hole looks like. So this is the hole for the locking tool that we're going to use and this is the bolt for the starter. So hope you're going to get the idea where you should plug the locking tool. After locking the crankshaft to the flywheel, here comes the biggest difference between the older and the newer generation M57. So, the camshafts on the older version, like on E39 and the first E60s, should be locked one by one. Right now, the intake camshaft is locked with the special tool. And just to help you, just to show you where is top dead center, you should look on the first two lobes of the camshaft. They should point to each other like that. Hope you can. They should point to each other like that. And on the newer generation M57, on the gear wheel of every camshaft, there is a dot. And these dots should point to each other when the cylinder one is on top dead center. So right now I'm going to lock this intake camshaft, and I'm going to remove the two gear wheels of the camshafts, so to be able to remove this chain. I'm going to remove it because I need to gain access down there, because there is one hidden bolt for the timing chain cover. I'm going to undo these two bolts. They are not reverse thread, they are normal thread. Of course I need to remove this plastic chain guide. I once again going to put this in place. Going to put the holding tool, going to thread it here to these threads. At least one of the camshafts to be locked. And when I'm installing the new chain, I'm going to lock the camshaft one by one. So this is the newer version on M57. Like you can see, guys, these are the two camshafts, and like you can see, the lobes are pointing on one side, not to each other, but on the left side, the both lobes pointing left side. And as you can see, on the two gear wheels we have dots, which should point to each other too. This is much easier way to do this engine. The newer generation is much easier to be timed. But doesn't matter, the older version is not so hard to, if you have the tool, because the tool is not so expensive, it's around 30 euro, so I think everyone can afford it. I forget to talk about the injector pump. The injector pump, the high fuel pressure injector pump, doesn't need to be timed. But now, before removing the cover, we're going to undo this bolt, let's say, this cap for the injector pump, which we're going to use H717. So, I'm going to undo this cap here, and after that I'm going to use this self-made tool to remove the gear of the injector pump. These tools are not so expensive, you can find it for around 20 or 30 euros, but before time it was much more expensive, so that's why I made my own back then. So now I'm going to show you how to do the job. It wasn't so hard. It's possible some oil to drip out from here, but tiny bit, only tiny bit.
Okay, no oil pitch.
And now we're going to use this tool. No, sorry, before that we're going to need to undo the nut which is inside. If I remember right, it was 19 millimeter. Okay, my mistake is 21 millimeter socket for this nut. it's going to be much more tighter than the cup itself. But not impossible. So now I'm going to use a special tool. This thread is going to be threaded to the gear wheel of the pressure pump. And this bolt is going to separate the gear wheel from the pump itself. So it just goes like that until it bites. I'm going to tighten it all the way. I don't want to damage the threads if I only attach it to one or two threads, so it's a good idea to thread it to the end. Okay, but now I'm going to take a ratchet and going to tighten this bolt so to be able to separate the gear wheel. Okay, this means the gear wheel is separated from the pump. So now I can undo the special tool and start removing the timing chain cover. So I think I undone everything for the timing chain cover. In total we have 12 with 10 millimeter socket bolts, 4 with hash 6 bolts, and 4 bolts from the oil pan from below, 1 long and 3 short. But we have one hidden bolt as under the gear wheel of the camshaft, so we have to undo these 2 bolts, which are E40 E14, to gain access to the hidden bolt for the cover itself. So now I'm going to remove the plastic guide, the 2 camshaft gears. So once again, it's not reverse thread like on the petrol ones, where the Vanus has a reverse thread bolt there. I have few of my friends that snapped this bolt because they did not know it was reverse thread. And this bolt is really hard to be found after that. So we removed this bridge and now we're going to remove the gear wheel of the camshaft. And now once again I'm going to undo this bolt and going to remove. And now there should be yes, we're going to need to remove this plastic guide to gain access to the bolt for the cover, because right now I can't see it from here. So I'm going to remove the guide and after that we're going to see for the bolt. So this is the plastic guide that I'm trying to remove. Like you can see, it holds by one bolt and here it just snaps to the body of the engine. So that's why I'm trying to pry it out. Okay, се изяжда. Не се родна?
Да. That's it.
Дискава клюкс. Okay, after removing everything, you can clearly see the hide and bolt down there in the middle of the screen. So I'm going to undo it and after that I'm going to remove the cover itself. So this is the new chain tensioner of the boat timing chains. And I want to... Как беше да им обясня? Нека на английски да им обясня.
To explain?
I want to explain you what I did wrong. So before removing the two camshaft gears, we need to find a way to compress the tensioner itself and after that lock it with this pin, because then it's going to be much more easier to do everything that I've done now. But I forget to compress the tensioner, that's why I had a little bit struggle with the plastic guides and everything. But if before you undo the two bolts, you need to press the chain down so to be able to compress the tensioner itself. Okay, so I undone the hide and bolt right there, and now it becomes the biggest struggle, removing the timing chain cover. So I'm going to show you where I'm going to pry it right there. It has a good gap for that. I'm going to use some lever and try to pry it out. Probably it's going to be a little bit struggle, but we're going to see how it works. Okay, so the timing chain cover is removed. So as you saw guys, I removed the chain cover without removing the oil pan. Just to show you that yes, it's possible, it's not a problem. But I'm still going to change the gasket of the oil pan, which is going to require to lower down the whole front suspension, the whole front axle. Because as I told you guys, most of the time when you do this and you don't change the oil pan gasket, there is going to be a leak after that sooner or later. Most of the time in the beginning, just in the beginning. So now I'm going to show you how to remove the other chain on the crankshaft. We'll be right back.